Hi, my name is Nick Morgan with Ludlum Measurements here in Sweetwater, Texas, where we've been building, engineering, and servicing radiation detection equipment for over 50 years. What we're going to do today is go over handheld equipment and doing a truck sweep to find the source that set off the gate monitor. What we're going to use right here is the model 30-6, which we've gone over in another video. It's got the 6-inch plastic scintillator. It's got the digital auto ranging readout, so you don't have to mess with any knobs. Simple to use, 3-button interface, extended reach. It's got a lot more sensitivity than the Model 19. And then we're also going to use the Model 19, which is your standard workhorse of the industry. You got your analog readout, analog knobs, toggle switches, reset button, battery check, steel casing, dust proof. Again, workhorse of the industry. What we're going to do is we're going to set up a cesium-137 source inside the truck. We're going to demonstrate a sweep. Again, if you've seen some of our other videos, cesium-137 is what we're going to be using, sealed source. These things are relatively harmless. It's not something you want to play with, but they're not going to hurt you. If you get a couple of thousand micro R readout, you've got to realize that it's not something that you need to be incredibly concerned with as far as your health goes. What we're going to do is we're going to demonstrate a proper sweep, and we're going to show the difference in sensitivity between the Model 19 and the Model 30-6. We've looked at the printout from the alarm sheet. It says it was about 25 feet back, which is about right in here somewhere. So we're just going to go with a range. Now we know where the source is, so rather than dragging the ladder out and scanning it from top to bottom like you would have to do in a real situation. What we're going to do is we're going to stand down here low where we can get too easy on the truck just for illustrative purposes. Whenever you first turn your monitor on, make sure your audio is turned on. It's going to take a background, but what you need to do whenever you get up close to the truck is hit the background reset button so that you're accounting for the background that's covered up by the truck before you start your sweep. You want to get close, you're doing a continuous motion, almost like you're painting a wall. You don't want to go fast, you don't want to get in a hurry, because you've got to give the monitor time to work. Slow, steady motions across the entire thing. Now you can hear the sound picking up. We've got it on the 25 scale and our needle is pegged out. So we know our source is right here. Bear in mind, with the Model 19, we know that this source is hidden directly on the other side of this steel. We'll do an experiment here in a second where we're going to hide it behind about 2 feet of steel. And that's going to give us a realistic expectation of what you might run into in the field. And it's going to give you an idea of the change on the readout. We had that needle pegged on the 250 MR range, or micro R range. And that was right behind right on the other side of this steel. Here in a second, we'll take a look and see what a difference 2 feet of steel shielding makes on the readout and how difficult it can be to find. Okay, now we're going to demonstrate the Model 30-6 with the extended reach, the 6-inch plastic scintillator, and the digital auto-ranging readout. First thing you'll do is you'll come, you'll turn it on. It's going to take an 8-second count to get a background radiation level, which we're going to have to reset anyways whenever we start the sweep of the truck. Whenever everything gets pulled up, make sure you look at your display. It'll give you a battery indication if you've got a low battery, and you want to make sure you've got plenty of juice when you're doing this. So what we're going to do is, again, we're going to come up to the side of the truck. Over here, we're going to push that button, and it's going to do another background. We want to set our background to what it is with the truck in the way, because that's what we're actually measuring. And remember, the sigma alarm on this adjusts the alarm point in the background for the sound. The readout's still going to be the same. If you get 300 micro-R, it's going to show 300 micro-R, which is the source, plus the background radiation. The sweep's going to be the same way. Slow and steady, like you're painting a wall. Notice whenever I got down low, there weren't a whole lot of truck there, it started to alert because it was reading some of the background. You do not want to get in a huge hurry on this, you want to be consistent. Probe that we've got in here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to hide that source between 2 feet of scrap steel so you can get a sense for what each one of these detectors will do whenever you're trying to do a truck sweep and you've actually got a load of steel in the truck. Take another measurement. We're going to do this, but now our source is hidden behind 2 feet of steel inside this trailer. We're going to show you the difference in what our readout on our detector is. We're going to start out with the 30-6 this time, which we read at about 110 micro-R per hour a second ago. We're going to sweep again and see what the difference in our readings is. Again, you bring it up to the trailer. Press the button temporarily until you see the countdown, then it's going to start resetting for an 8 count to adjust your background. And then we'll start the sweep. Close is not a bad thing. Thank you. 2 feet of shielding being right up against the side of the truck. You really got to be paying attention because sometimes it'll be small jumps that'll make the difference. We're fortunate in this case because we know where the source is, so we know that we're keying on the right thing. But if you're scanning the load to set up your gate monitors, you're going to have to be very aware and you're going to have to pay close attention to the detector. And that was with the 30-6. Now we're going to show you with the model 19 the difference and attention that you're going to have to pay, because sometimes the jumps you're seeing are going to be very minimal. Okay, now we're going to do a sweep with the model 19. First thing, you'll turn it on, turn it down to the lowest range, check your battery, same as always. Whenever you come up to the truck, hit reset on your background so it adjusts back to zero, and then you'll start your sweep. But the model 19 has only a 1-inch probe compared to the 6-inch probe. You turn your audio on. As you can see, I just made a mistake. Model 19, we have a 1-inch probe compared to a 6-inch on the 30-6. So you've got to be very, very attentive to what you're reading and your needle is doing as you're doing a sweep. Our background started out at about 4 mR. Here, which I don't know if you can see this on the camera or not, we jumped from about 4.5 on our background up to about 9 µA. That's a really small and insignificant jump, but whenever you're dealing with an entire load of steel, even an insignificant jump can possibly indicate that you have a radiation source within the load. You don't know if it's right up against the wall, and you don't know if it's buried right in the middle of the load. We know this one in particular is behind 2 feet of steel, which is why we're getting such a small jump. We're only about 3.5, 4 to about 8 µA per hour. So that's why your operators need to be very attentive to the readings that they're getting on these devices whenever they're doing these sweeps. This that we've demonstrated for you is a really good exercise to do with your new people to the yard so that you can train them on what it's like to actually look for a radiation source. It's not always going to show up as something big. It could be something very small as a 10 microcurie cesium-137 source, which again, relatively harmless, but it's still a radioactive source that you want to get and you want to get taken care of properly.